Okay, so remember last week we talked about how Elon met with Herbert Diess, who is the head of VW, and they met at an airstrip in Germany, and they talked about something, and we conjectured they were talking about what?
Parcheesi.
Yes.
And cooking and raves. No, we also really thought that they were talking about superchargers, because Volkswagen's just coming out with their ID.3 now. They're soon to be coming out with the ID.4, which we'll talk about in a little bit. But we were saying, wouldn't it be kind of a good partnership if Volkswagen would help pay for the Tesla supercharger network, and in return, Tesla would allow VW to use their charging network?
Well, guess what happened? Look at this story here. We get word from Next Move in Germany. So thank you, Stefan, so much for this footage and photos. Stefan Moeller was able to show that a VW ID.3 could charge here.
And that's a supercharger.
Yes. So this could really point to that what we talked about last week could be real.
But that was not the only car that could charge at the supercharger. You could also charge a Taycan, which I know you're like, but that's also VW. But you could also do a Kia Niro, which is not VW, an Opel Ampera E, which is essentially the European Bolt. Also the BMW i3, the Kona, the Renault Zoe, and also the e-Golf. So, I mean, all of these different electric cars could suddenly charge at the Tesla supercharger network. Now, I don't think that Tesla inked a deal with all of these companies all at the same time.
It's a bug. It must be a bug.
So that's weird, though. That's weird. Don't you think that that's a weird...
It's not a bug.
...bug?
Can you guys see between the lines? Can you read between the lines here? They met. And I bet they didn't agree on everything. They probably didn't agree on the price. I bet Herbert said, oh, Elon, can we use your charging network? It would be awesome.
Well, you're probably going to create a bunch of demand for chargers, which means that we're going to need a big outlay of new superchargers.
No problem. We'll build like 10 more.
No. You don't fully understand. It's probably going to be 100% capacity increase, which means that we're going to need to basically double the chargers, especially in Europe.
How about 15?
No. You don't. Oh, all right. Listen, I'll show you what I mean. So what I think could have happened is, whether they agreed or didn't agree, whatever, I think that this is kind of, and again, this could be a bug or could not be a bug, but is a golden opportunity for Tesla to show, A, the excitement of other EV owners using the supercharger network, proving that it can work. So that way, because for the longest time, you just thought that if you plug those things together, there'd be an explosion. Not the case. Now, you know that they're going to charge with every car. So what Tesla can do is start gathering data while they have this bug. They could be having this bug or not. There are going to be some VINs that are unaccounted for. And they can simply go, well, during the period of our bug, we noticed an increased demand at all of our chargers by 30%, 40%, 50%, whatever. So that can both inform where they might want to put new chargers. It can also say, hey, we weren't even telling people that they could do this, and we noticed a bump, which means that we can take whatever number we have, multiply it by 11, and that will be the number of chargers that we need. And then they can take that to Volkswagen, Kia, all these other companies and say, here is what we expect you to pay if you'd like to use the charging network. Plus, we also need to work out some way to charge customers.
I would also like to make a second conjecture,
okay,
since I'm riding on the high of my first one. Herbert Diess was checking out the Model Y last week, and he said some really nice things. He said, this car is for us in many aspects, not in all, a reference. User experience, updatability, driving features, performance of the top of the range models, charging network, and range. So conjecture alert. Mm-hmm. Hey, conjecture time. So last week I conjectured that VW and Tesla might have been working on a deal to have VW use the supercharger network. And regardless of what Diess said, just to be clear, we just drove the ID.3 and had a chat. There is no deal cooperation in the making. So let me conjecture some more. What if Elon was asking Herbert to come work for Tesla as head of Euro operations?
But Zach, why would he want to leave Volkswagen? Isn't he the chairman of Volkswagen?
He's actually been demoted. Everyone kind of forgets the news story that came out over the summer where he's been moved down to head of VW Group, but he's not the CEO of VW anymore. So he's been demoted. That can't feel too good.
Right.
And he's always been pushing for electrics. So wouldn't he make kind of the perfect head of Tesla Europe? He knows everyone there.
Yes. Yeah. He would just need to basically change offices and have almost the same job except working for a arguably much better company. Yeah, because like, why would you just meet someone at an airport? Like, that's kind of weird, right? That doesn't, you know, usually you'd be like, oh, come back to the headquarters. You'll meet all the guys.
Yeah.
Oh, we'll be in the boardroom talking about stuff, not in a car by ourselves.
The two heads of the companies are alone in a car for a while.
Right.
Hey, everybody. Thanks so much for watching Now You Know Clips.
You can watch full episodes of Tesla Time News on Mondays and in-depths on Fridays. Just click the link down below to head over to the Now You Know channel.